Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Newsreel 2005. Our first item actually took place last year in Towneley Park with the Sea Cadets. There to record the event was our reporter, Alan Hardman.
Towneley Park is bathed in all its autumn glory this Sunday afternoon, the 17th of October 2004. We are here to witness the presentation and dedication of a new colour for the Burnley Pendle and Rossendale Sea Cadets. The funding has been raised with support from the Royal Marines Association, the Rossendale White Ensign Association and the Burnley Ex-Naval Association. The service of dedication is being led by Mr. Keith Stewart, who is the Northwest Area Chaplain to the Sea Cadets. Civic representatives from the three boroughs of Burnley Pendle and Rossendale are here to show their support. Councillor Jeff Cheetham, the Deputy Mayor of Rossendale, is inspecting the Guard of Honour. After a lovely early afternoon, the weather has turned decidedly damp, but I don't think it's dampened the spirit of those taking part.
Gathered here together for the presentation of T.S. Lookout's colour as members of the Sea Cadet Corps. As we go about our duties, we ask the blessing of Almighty God on all that we do, that we may grow in our service to God and others, so that working together, we may learn how to be God's true people. We pray this day especially for T.S. Lookout and ask that all that we do may be...
The former commanding officer of TS Lookout, Captain Roger Mackerel, has been given the honour of taking the salute at the march past. Mr. Alan Pigeon, seen here in the Deerstalker, was one of the first to join the Sea Cadets. That was before the Second World War. Here he encourages three young recruits who've travelled all the way from Holyhead to be here this afternoon. The procedures are over. Guess what? The rain has stopped.
Towneley Hall was the venue on Bank Holiday Monday the 30th of May, when the Eskerfeld Medieval Society staged a unique entertainment.
A tournament of armed combat, realistically reproducing those of the 13th century, between knights and full armour. Eskerfeld is the pre-Norman name for Sheffield, where the society, founded in 1973, is based. It is one of the oldest and finest of the UK's foot combat groups.
Come on, take that. It was a lovely day as the runners assembled in Towneley Park to participate in the annual Race for Life in memory of their loved ones.
Than that. Listen, ladies, are we feeling fantastic?
Yeah!
Are we going to show them what Girl Power can do today?
Yeah!
Woo! I like it. You lot are saucy, aren't you? Hey, I've heard about you lot. Saw you warming up when I came. Brilliant. It's going to be a lovely day.
And you? Do you mean it's the one over there?
Now, have you dressed up as well? I've seen some...
whether you're running or walking, I'd like to say a big thank you to TESCO.
Most of all, enjoy it, have a laugh and have a sing song. So if we're ready, march it out. Pop, sing along. La la la, sha la 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 la.
After a warm-up session, the race got underway. The eventual winner came home in a record time, but in reality, everyone was a winner.
Proud to be part of them today. Yeah,
definitely.
And you're obviously used to running them.
Yeah. It's sort of my hobby. I'm out of the house for an hour.
I normally go shopping, that normally sorts me out, but you look wonderful. Congratulations, you've been fantastic. We'll see you again next year.
Yes,
definitely. Yvonne, everyone!
The 75th anniversary of Thompson Park was celebrated on the 16th of July. Attractions included chainsaw sculpture, birds of prey, model boat regatta, and many community stalls.
So I'll have the peacock, you can have the tub.
The main attraction appeared to be the opening by the Mayor of Burnley of the extension to the existing track of the model railway. The trains were very popular, with many people taking a ride.
It's great to see the Burnley camcorder group down here at the Burnley Balloon Festival. Down here on the 31st of July 2005.
This year is the fourth year the event has been staged and is the biggest yet.
Well, the kind of thing you notice when you do come into a balloon, oh, if you like, I promise I might be back, is that there's no sensation of air on your face because you're moving with the wind. Golf course over here, isn't it? That's going to upset the golf people, isn't it, really?
Most of these balloons have got two sets of burners on them. One high-pressure burner, which will be burning with a blue flame, which Trish will be using now to get as much heat in as quickly as possible.
What goes up must come down. Other events taking place included a karate demonstration by two local clubs.
Prepare to be stunned as you witness the exciting spectacle of the over-the-top motorcycle stunt team.
We will rock you.
A lucky spectator also has the chance to join in.
Tight hold, you ready? You ready? Whoa! What a big jump from the boys! Now, two of the finest jumpers in the UK.
Fairground with its variety of roundabout stalls and stomach-turning rides is a lively attraction. As also were the ever-popular bumping cars. Undoubtedly, the highlight of the weekend was the cleverly orchestrated balloon glow with its accompanying magnificent display of fireworks.
Built on the site of the old cattle market, Burnley Police Station opened 50 years ago. Today on its anniversary, members of the public were invited along to look around and meet some of the officers. This busy control room handles about 850 emergency calls a week. 92% are answered within 10 seconds. The patrol cars and cameras are always a popular attraction, although I'm not so sure some of the mums and dads might agree on that point.
Sorry, fella. Come in.
Bullets, it just fires blanks, right? And we use this in our dog training scenarios.
I later spoke to one of the handlers from a safe distance and asked him a couple of questions about his dogs.
Devon is Black German Shepherd about 2 years, and Rory the Labrador I've had him about 6 years now.
Have you ever been bitten?
A couple of times by my own dog and once by another handler's dog, yeah, unfortunately.
Held at Padiham Town Hall, the Mayor's annual tea dance on the 9th of August was well attended by the invited guests. Also in attendance were the mayors from around the borough.
My sister Pauline, and we'd like to welcome everybody here. We'll do it in the order of the top table. Could I welcome all the mayors and mayoresses of the various Lancashire boroughs and their representatives, because they're sent representatives as well. So thank you very much for coming and supporting us. And could I also thank the people of Padiham and the other ladies and gentlemen who are here today, particularly for coming, and also for buying the raffle tickets. I've been looking around and I can see raffle tickets on virtually every table, and that's very good of you. It will go obviously to the Mayoress's committee, and we will be supporting a charity for local people in Pendle, Burnley and Rossendale. It's the Child Development Centre, which is based at Readley Hall, between Burnley and Nelson. But we're very happy that you're here. We hope that you've enjoyed the dancing that you're engaged in. You won't see me dancing because I'm suffering from migraine today, so there's no me dancing. But thank you for coming. So I'll let them carry on with the draw. Thank you.
The raffle in aid of the Mayor's charity was very well supported.
I'm here with you today to help draw. And what's your name?
George.
George. So, George, if you would like to prepare one of those, please.
This is for the main raffle.
Yeah, this is for the main raffle, which is the corner one at the top there.
Yellow.
Right, the first number is 63. Yellow.
All yellow.
Are they all yellow?
Yes, oh. All yellow.
Oh, yes, the grandson has got grandma's.
Well, I think that's it. Give the number.
2, 1, 6.
That first.
Thank you very much.
August the 14th brought another fine day to Towneley, with a good turnout of about 50 vintage motors, many in pristine condition for today's annual event. Including this 1914 Model T, imported from Texas in 97 as a wreck. And this luxury 1966 Mercedes-Benz 230 SL. Some of the cars have been completely rebuilt from a pile of old bits and pieces. His Worship the Mayor was obviously enjoying this fine spectacle of old motors, and I asked him how long had he been a keen enthusiast.
Ever since I was a small boy. I mean, I suppose all boys are interested in cars, but I was born in just after the war, and when there weren't all that many new cars coming out, and as new cars came out, even though I was only a small boy, I used to look to see what they were. I suppose my favourite one was the Alvis. I used to love Alvises. Alvises was my ambition in life, to own an Alvis. But unfortunately, in 1967, when I was about 19, Alvises ceased production when the Rover Group took them out. And they took them over, should I say. But I've always been interested in cars, like everybody, I suppose, of my age group, but particularly in British cars of the 1950s and 60s. Those are the ones that interest me most.
The cavalcade will make its way from here to Helmshaw Museum after first calling in at the Weaver's Triangle, with refreshments available at the Inn on the Wharf. Alcohol in moderation, I'm sure, on this occasion.
Thousands of people turned out on Sunday the 21st of August this year to enjoy a combination of the Burnley Festival and the Burnley Carnival. Keeping the teenagers happy on the main stage were some very talented groups. Whilst out in the sun, others were enjoying the rest of the activities. For the more sedate amongst us, once again, Katie Roberts was entertaining on her harp. Katie has quite a number of harps, most of which she builds herself. The carnival procession was a great success, delighting many Burnley residents as it made its way through the town and back to the festival. The Mayor of Burnley, Councillor Roger Frost, was in attendance to oversee all the day's activities. Back at the festival, a young man shows us his skills on the manual lathe. The two events are usually held on separate weekends, and organiser Mike Bailey was worried there would not be enough volunteers if held together. But it was a great success, and everybody had an enjoyable and memorable day.
On a beautiful summer's day in August, an open day at the Horse Rescue Centre, HAPPA, Shorthay Farm, was well supported by young and old. Many of the horses that you see have been neglected and in very poor condition when they arrived at the farm. But with lots of love, care and attention, they now stand proudly in their boxes, giving us the pleasure of touching them and talking to them. There was a never-ending queue of people attracted by the aroma of barbecued food. Many fundraising activities took place in the field behind the stables. For a small donation, your dog could try its skill at the obstacle course run by the Burnley Dog Rescue. Even the sanctuary's goat entertained us. One last look at the stables before the judging of the best turned out ponies and horses which have been adopted by these children.
Well done, Hayden. Nice view you have. There are no losers. If we can just, if anybody wants to come in a group, touch the ponies, we'll be doing the draw in a couple of minutes' time.
August the 27th this year brought us Briercliffe's annual flower show, which once again was part of the very busy schedule of our mayor and mayoress. They arrived bright and cheerful at Haggate School on Burnley Road, looking forward to seeing some colourful exhibits, and they were not disappointed. Vegetables, fruit, floral art and handicraft, along with a lovely selection of flowers, were displayed. This event was recently restarted by the Briercliffe Society and organised by the Briercliffe Allotment and Gardening Society. The Mayor, as President of the Briercliffe Society, presented the prizes.
This year, to have with us the Mayor and Mayoress of the Borough, Roger and his sister Pauline, and they've come along this afternoon to present the awards. Susan Meeks, the secretary, will read out, "You look at me." Thank you very much.
Village Policeman Trophy for Both Points in Red Section is Terry Hinton.
The presentation of prizes brought to a close a very enjoyable and colourful afternoon.
The windy morning of the 28th of August was ideal for the open day at Clough Wind Farm, situated on the long causeway above Burnley. Operational from December 1992, it produces sufficient electricity to supply 6,000 homes without any atmospheric pollution.
I'm Amy Hinks, I work for RES Limited and we own part of this wind farm.
What is the objective of today's event?
It's a national event. It's the first time that all the wind farms all over the country have been opened up to the general public, and we're trying to show people, dispel a few of the myths surrounding wind farms, show people what they're all about, let people see inside the turbines, because people don't often get a chance to do that, and also to get people to pledge their support for wind energy by putting their handprints on the turbines, which is what we've been doing today.
What do you consider to be the ecological implications?
Well, when we build a wind farm, we have to look at a lot of things. So, first of all, we have to find a site that's not constrained by a landscape protection area. So we can't build in national parks, we can't build them very often in areas of outstanding natural beauty. We work with the RSPB to try and work out if there's any important bird populations in the area. If the RSPB have got any concerns, then we wouldn't go ahead with that site. We look at local towns and how close they are to the nearest house. We need them to be a good couple of hundred metres from the nearest house, and ideally we try and go for about 800 metres. And then there's all the positive benefits as well. So this wind farm here is supplying energy for about 6,000 homes. And these are fairly old turbines, they're quite small by modern standards, so the ones we're building now, a wind farm this size, will probably supply about 10 or 20,000 homes. So it's all around just making sure we get a good site and then making sure everyone knows about the good benefits of it.
Thank you.
Local residents worked alongside their local police officers and Burnley Council's park rangers to launch the very first Pact In The Park event.
So welcome everybody to the first Pact In The Park event in Burnley, in Ightenhill Park now. I'd like to ask
The Mayor of Burnley, accompanied by his Mayoress, had a lovely summer's day to open this great fun day.
Good afternoon everybody. I've got a little speech here, but you'll be glad to know it's only a little speech. As you've just been told, this is the first event of its kind in this park, and it's something that we've got two or three green flags in the borough, which is a great achievement, and we'd like to see this park improved. I'd like to declare the fun day and community consultation open. Thank you.
The event took part on the 4th of September, and Ightenhill Park was bathed in sunshine.
Moving just a little bit that way.
The Mayor and Mayoress also planted a tree to celebrate the Ightenhill Community Initiative.
That's lovely. Okay.
Haven't got my batch in it.
And again.
You're a little bit tired.
There's always one tired day. That's to stop us. That's to tell us that this is as far as we come.
I asked the Mayor a little bit about the event.
Well, the idea of the event today is to get the community involved in the future of the park. The park will have to survive in the future with a partnership with the Borough Council and other potential partners. So the idea is to bring people together, get their views and start the process from there.
I also asked him how he was enjoying his year in office.
It's been very hard work, I've got to admit. I've not been all that well recently and I didn't realise there'd be so much to do. but it's been very enjoyable. I mean, I've met a lot of interesting people. I've been coming out to Ightenhill. It's a place I normally wouldn't come to the park anyway. Except that I suppose I ought to admit that I'm the clerk to the parish council, but the bowling green isn't in the parish council. I'm enjoying meeting people, and I'm sure the mayoress is as well, and that's one of our roles, is to meet people and carry their message back to the council, which we do.
And for those wanting to relax in the sun, there was the Silver Alliance brass band. One of the most popular activities of the day was the dog show. There was about a 15-minute wait for ice cream. The day was a great success and the organisers are hoping to do the same again next year.
28 years old this year, founded in 1935.
Once again, our Mayor and Mayoress are out and about amongst the folk of Burnley. This weekend, along with many other dignitaries, they're at Gawthorpe Hall, celebrating 70 years of voluntary action.
Perhaps renew itself and think about its future. It is significant that we are here.
The CSS has an affiliated membership of local organisations.
some of whose names are now shrouded in the historical mists of time. People who've been on adventure courses.
Saturday, the 24th of September, was a beautiful day for this great occasion, opened by Deputy Lieutenant of the CVS, Susan Hughes.
And I wish you all well for the future and have great pleasure in opening your 70th birthday anniversary celebrations.
Some of the entertainment for the day was provided by the Burnley Junior Alliance Band.
Well, today's event has been set up because the Council for Voluntary Service is celebrating 70 years of having done coordination of voluntary groups and practical welfare social work in the community. It's since 1935 that this organisation has been going. It's changed its approaches to things, it's certainly changed its name because, as I said earlier, it was the Council for Social Service, it's now the Council for Voluntary Service. But long may it continue because there is a need out there in the community. Voluntary organisations need to be coordinated, and that's what the CVS does in a very appropriate and efficient way.
We decided we wanted to have a showcase event to celebrate all the work that not just the CVS have done, but all the voluntary groups amongst the whole area. If you think Burnley, Pendle and Rossendale is a huge, great geographical area. Amongst that area, there's over 2,000 voluntary organisations. So what we like to do is support them.
We thought there was a need within Briercliffe where people don't have as much disposable income to actually have their own. But even if they have a computer, they might not be able to afford to go on the internet.
Many voluntary organisations were represented, and all the dignitaries spent most of the day walking round talking and taking a great deal of interest in the representatives from the various organisations. For those of a more Caribbean bent, the Bard and Steel Band provided some very colourful entertainment. The event was a great success, which was helped by a beautiful sunny day.
Thursday the 27th of October, and Burnley Football Club are nervously waiting for the arrival of His Royal Highness Prince Charles at 10:15 a.m. He was met by the High Sheriff of Lancashire, Mr. James Armfield, OBEDL, the Mayor of Burnley, Councillor Roger Frost, the Mayoress of Burnley, Mrs. Pauline Frost Hardwick, and Mr. Barry Kilby, the Chairman of Burnley Football Club, and Mr. David Edmondson, Burnley Football Club's Chief Executive. Nine-year-old Ellie Fleming was delighted when the Royal Age invited her to have a chat with Prince Charles.
Nine. And what
which school do you go to?
St. John's Junior.
In Burnley?
Yeah.
Yeah. So you're on half term at the moment?
Yeah.
Yeah? And it wasn't it nice that you were the only one that sort of got in there? Yeah.
What did Prince Charles say to you?
He said, is anybody with you? I said, yeah, my nana.
Yeah.
And they said, where are you going today? And I said, we're going down to town.
Pupils from the St. Peter's and Westthorne Primary Schools were outside the James Hargrave Suite to greet Prince Charles when he came out. Inside the James Hargrave Suite, there had been a short presentation on Burnley Football Club's Sport in the Community scheme, on the Get Off the Bench programme, and the opportunity for the Prince to see a group of people training in the School Citizen Anti-Racism in Football scheme. Inside the sports hall, after watching young people training in football techniques and cricketing skills, Prince Charles signs a visitor's book before being presented with a framed photograph of the football stadium. So it's farewell to His Royal Highness Prince Charles as he moves on to Nelson on this perfect autumn morning.
The 28th of October brought us to a very eerie Thompson Park, an event for the children. I asked park ranger Stephen Richards a little more about it.
We do this Halloween walk every year for the last 3 years. We've been doing three walks, 6 o'clock, half past six, and 7 o'clock we've gone on the ghost rides. One or two ghosts will be jumping about. We've got some owls coming, Molly and Mia, which have just arrived. As we speak, some barn owls the kids can touch. Just a fun event, cups of tea, and it's just for the community.
That's it, that's it.
It was now getting quite dark, but still the children and parents were arriving for their Halloween night. The children had to first register before being taken in groups through what was now a very dark park to the waiting ghost trains.
Excuse me. Look at that. Did you see that?
The evening was well attended and very well policed, The park rangers did a sterling job keeping everyone safe. The kids and parents had a wonderful evening, and everyone enjoyed the well-organised event. We hope you all made your donations and pledges last Friday to children in need. Our final report comes from Tesco's on the 16th of this month, where Radio Lancashire broadcasts live with their appeal. Anyone listening to Radio Lancashire at 9 a.m. that morning would have heard the Ted Robbins programme start like this.
It is the great, the late, the wonderful. Where have you been, Ted Robbins?
You'll have to.
The man in the fluorescent jacket's looking at you already.
Big clamp on him, hasn't he? Watch out for that. We're at Tesco. Yo, it's Wednesday. I heard you say the pantechnicon rode into town. Get me out of this car now.
Right, well, let's right. Get the door. We'll just get the door.
Hoist.
Mind these bollards.
Watch me bollard.
I think we've just squashed his leg. Come on, out you come now.
Chauffeur-driven.
You want me to push you?
Yes.
Here.
Come on in. Come on. Mini. There you go.
Size.
He's out. He's out of the car. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is. Oh. The legend, Ted Robbins.
A travelator.
It's a travelator.
I asked Ted about his programme coming live from Tesco's.
Good morning to Burnley Camcorder Group. Ted Robbins here, broadcasting live for you. BBC Radio Lancashire, as part of Children in Need 2005, out on the road on our supermarket tour. We have a highly trained team of young, enthusiastic people. If you'd like to just pan camera left down to our on-air producer, Ms. Leanne Pilkington, who also works part-time.
Is that the other voice?
That's a voiceover. Here we have... Now, this is very interesting for you. Here we have, in one person, Ant and Deck. Say good morning, Ant and Deck.
Good morning.
Now say in your Geordie Newcastle accent.
How are you, man?
Why, I.
How are you doing?
Blade and Races. So that's just two of us, and we are here. The serious side of this is to raise lots of money for children in need. And I've brought me a bag of pennies that have been... We found down the back of the sofa. There they all are. Bits of fluff on them.
Marvellous.
Look, there's a licorice also.
We've been looking for that for weeks.
And there we have one of our senior broadcast journalists, BBC Radio Lancashire. That's Ben Thompson. So there we are. So hope to have a good day. We're going to set up for business and make loads and loads of money. Ted Robbins, News at 10, sober.
After meeting up with Pudsey Bear, Ted and his team spent the morning greeting everyone as they came into the store.
Speak, Pudsey.
No.
Where's Anton Deck? Have you seen it?
Ted also kept himself very busy with various interviews, one of which was with singer Sally Jacks. And with the Pendle Jazzmen playing in the background, the day went very well. The final item on Ted's show was the quiz, after which he had to hand back to Brett Davis in the studio.
Who got married in Coronation Street?
Put the timer on!
Oh, it was Les and Cilla. But Carol, that you won anything at all is a miracle, quite frankly. But we love your laugh and have a great time with your show. Call me again once the Valium's kicked in. All right, Carol. Brett, over to you, pal, with the best of luck. Well, thank you very much, everybody. What a, the 3 hours have gone by in a flash. Knackered now, but been giving some chuckies. But had a good day. We've raised lots of money for children in need. How much have we raised, Ben?
Well, we nearly sold out of stock, so it must be another £500-600 today.
And the rice appeal for the Malawian orphans and the famine there. I think we've got over 240. That's today. They're going to carry on collecting. That's great. So there we are. A good day. Ted Robbins going to have a collapse now for half an hour. And lots of love to you lot. Cheers.
So here we are at the end of another newsreel. Newsreel 2005 has been great fun to be involved in, and we hope you've enjoyed watching it as much as we've enjoyed making it. So good night to you all, and see you again next year.